And now we would like to welcome on the program, honored to have His Excellency Ramon A. Bagatsing Jr., the Ambassador Extraordinaire and Plenipotentiary of the Republic of the Philippines to the Republic of India. Welcome to the program, Mr. Ambassador.
Thank you very much, Alba. It's a pleasure to talk to all of you there.
Ambassador, how are you? We would like to ask first, how is your condition over there in India? How are you, po?
But we're all okay so far. With the Filipino community, fortunately, wala po masyadong adverse effect on virus dito sa mga kababayan natin. Mm-hmm. And mag-roll out na on India for all other residents of India. So starting April 1, they will allow diplomats like me and the others to take the vaccine. Mm-hmm. In spite of the fact that there are some states here right now that medyo tumataas ang incidence.
Yes. True. Ambassador, could you give us the general situation in India with regards to the pandemic, and how is the government coping with the rise in new cases of these new variants?
Well, right now there are about 11.8 million citizens who have had the virus. 11.8, and out of that, siguro mga 163 ang namatay. And so far, as far as the vaccination rollout is concerned, they've had about 55 million citizens already na nakatanggap na ng vaccine. Mm-hmm. And they're targeting by end of August about 300 million. Mm-hmm. And as I said, fortunately for us, they're opening it up starting April 1 to even non-citizens. Mm-hmm. And 45 years old and above. Mm-hmm. So ngayon, yung mga 60 years old and above, mabibigyan nila ng pakuna, but starting on April 1, only Thursday, then open it up.
Mm-hmm. Situation of our Filipino community there, ilan po ba ang Filipinos natin dyan po sa India?
More or less about 3,000, and most of them, 80% are housewives. Ito yung mga kababayan natin na napangasawa, mga Indias, no? Mostly what we call Middle East romances, or some of them internet, mm-hmm, or media. Mm-hmm. And fortunately again for us, isa lang may napisala sa atin na kababayan natin. Last year pa, nung nag-umpisa ang pandemic. Mm-hmm. But since that time, we have not any deaths, no, na Pilipino. Mm-hmm. And as I said, we're very lucky na all of them are safe, they're sound, they're healthy, and that they can avail of the vaccine once this is available to everybody, you know, starting April 1. Mm-hmm. Swerte tayo na walang kababayan tayo dito ang kinamaan ng seryoso. Mm-hmm.
Is it for free po, the vaccines?
Yes, libre ito sa lahat ng mga Indians and those who want to go to the clinics. But may mga public clinics sila na libre. Ngayon, if you go to a hospital, a private hospital, and you also pay for the vaccine, I'm paying 250 rupees. Mm-hmm. Or about maybe 200 pesos. So, napakamura ng bakuna dito, no, sa mga kababayan natin dito sa India, sa mga Indians. Mm-hmm. 200 pesos ang pinakasigil nila, mm-hmm, sa mga private hospitals. But if you go to a public hospital, it's free.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How are we... Yung Filipino community po natin dyan, sinabi nyo na they can get for free also, or kung ano man, murang-mura lang talaga yung vaccination po natin. Are there Filipinos who have been vaccinated already? And have you been vaccinated po?
I am scheduled to take mine this Friday, Good Friday. Mm-hmm. Okay, but dito sa embassy staff natin, may mga nakakuha doon ng vaccine last week. So, yung mga above 60, they can go anytime. Mm-hmm. And as I said, yung mga Pilipino, they can go to a public hospital or public clinic and it's, mm-hmm, given for free. Mm-hmm. Yung pag pumunta ka sa private hospital or private clinic, you, mm-hmm, pay 250 rupees. Mm-hmm. So, the embassy staff will be probably going this week with me. Mm-hmm. And we'll go to the private clinic and we'll have our vaccines taken. Mm-hmm. And then we have announced this also to the Filipino community na pwede na silang pumunta maski na sa hospital or clinic, and they can get it for free or they pay only so much.
Mm-hmm.
Maganda naman ang aming kooperasyon dito sa PhilCom. We met with them last week.
Mm-hmm.
They're very grateful for the assistance given by the embassy to them.
Mm-hmm.
And we notify them also for the developments sa atin. At isang magandang issue dito sa atin, Alma, is that karangalan natin to, dahil yung head ng WHO dito sa India ay Pilipino, si Dr. Mm-hmm. Of Reed.
Mm-hmm.
So, yung mga kinikwento niya sa amin, anong dapat gawin, anong hindi dapat gawin,
yes.
Ay nakaka-scoop tayo, ang Filipino community, dahil Filipino nga ang head. No? Karangalan natin yan, binubong India.
Indeed. Yes, sir.
Yeah, with 1.3 billion people at the vaccine capital of the world,
yes.
Filipino. Kasi yung mga vaccines na pinamibigay sa mundo, India is the biggest, vaccine capital of the world.
Yes.
India produces at least 50 to 60% of all the vaccines in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Yung Serum Institute of India, yan ang gumagawa ng AstraZeneca, they produce 60-70% of the vaccines. No? And yung Bharat Biotech, they are rolling out also their own local, their local version sila.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And yung local version, Covaxin ang tawag, out of the 55 million administered dito sa India, 50 million is yung AstraZeneca. O may local brand din sila tawag dito, Poly Shield. 5 million dyan yung gawa ng India, which is called Covaxin.
Mm-hmm.
And we're both working na itong mga bakuna na ito ay maidala dyan sa Pilipinas.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Si Secretary, pumunta dito. Second of March 9 to 12,
uh-huh.
wala magpirma ng kontrata para sa Novavax. Yung isang bakuna para gagawin ng India.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned about Covaxin. Actually, a presidential advisor for entrepreneurship, Joey Concepcion, said the private sector is expected to receive 1 million doses of India's Covaxin this April, Ambassador.
Yes, Alma. If we're lucky, awan ng Diyos, makuha yung EUA dyan magmula sa FDA, no?
Mm-hmm.
Pag makuha yan next week, then they can start exporting them.
Mm-hmm.
At ang ating dinalakad ngayon with the help of Joey Concepcion, as you mentioned, and Ambassador Kumaran, yung ambassador ng India sa Pilipinas,
mm-hmm.
we're working on 8 million doses coming from Bharat Biotech.
Yes.
I said, if we get all the approvals from the FDA, hopefully, baka Mayo, may dumating na dyan ang mga 8 million. Hindi naman sabay yung 8 million eh.
Mm-hmm.
Tranches, mga 600,000.
Mm-hmm.
And the second tranche will be about 2-3 million.
Mm-hmm.
Up to the end of the year, we're working at 8 million doses. And as I said, if we're lucky, baka madagdagan pa yan.
Mm-hmm.
Ang importante is makuha natin yung mga approvals.
Yes. You mentioned also about the Bharat Biotech's Covaxin. In its phase 3 trials, it demonstrated 81% interim efficacy in preventing the coronavirus in those without prior infection after the second dose. Actually, the price is still being negotiated. Can you tell us more about this exciting development that you mentioned, Ambassador?
Yes, as I said, masipag ito si Joey Concepcion. Yung kanyang negosyo, no?
Mm-hmm.
And nagkaroon na kami ng webinar noon to talk with the private sector that this is a very safe vaccine, no less than the president of the prime minister and president of India, si Prime Minister Modi.
Mm-hmm.
At saka si President Comin,
mm-hmm.
ay nag-take dito at yung mga karami na kanyang mga cabinet secretaries. So ito ang ni-roll out nila and maganda naman ang feedback. Walang mga serious adverse effects.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya ang dami pumipila ngayon na bansa na kunin dito po vaccine. Kaya nakapila tayo. Ang importante, makadesisyon na tayo ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
Para mapatalan yan at as soon as possible time.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, if we're lucky, 8 million yan, it's going to be a tripartite agreement. Marami mga MGUs na nakalista doon at saka mga korporasyon na nakalista doon.
Mm-hmm.
Mapadala dyan, okay na. Kung sakali swerte pa tayo, makahingi tayo ng donasyon, ng 100,000 or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So, but this is purely a public-private partnership, including the MGUs.
Mm-hmm.
And the feedback has been very favorable. Sa mga nakakausap ko dito, mga Indian na nakakuha ng Covaxin,
mm-hmm.
wala na daw silang sinasabing serious adverse effects. No?
Mm-hmm.
So, they're okay with that.
Mm-hmm. So from a positive perspective, India, no, despite a sudden rise in cases, is confident in its vaccination program. It is even exporting vaccines with a high efficacy rate. No, no, po. Actually, you mentioned about Covaxin. Just a little bit of background. Two-dose vaccine, 28 days apart, no sub-zero storage requirement. Tapos ready-to-use vials po. No reconstitution requirement. Ang galing po, ano?
Correct. Kasi yung iba, yung ano mga major manufacturer ngayon, China, US, UK, and then India.
Mm-hmm.
So itong barat, biotechnology o yung Covaxin at saka yung darating na Novavax, 2 to 8 degrees Celsius lang yan. So walang heavy refrigeration na kinakailangan.
Okay.
So mas madaling i-handle.
Opo.
No? Two doses, as you said, it can be 28 days, but in some instances, it can be 4 weeks, no? 1 month, no? or more.
Mm-hmm.
But as I said, wala masyadong serious side effect. At saka mura. Compared to the others, it's cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
So, tahimik na tayo dito nagtatrabaho. Ang importante kasi mapadala na dyan. Ang importante tumating dyan at ma-jab sa ating mga shoulders.
Mm-hmm. May iba po tayo sandali. How are the travel restrictions and inbound and outbound India po?
Napaka-stricto, Alma. Napaka-stricto. No? Same thing, Philippines and India, hindi pwede mga turista. Okay, very strict sila. The usual exemptions lang ang mga diplomats, medical workers, emergency, seafarers. So yung mga Pilipino gusto pumunta dito o maging turista lang, we discourage that. At hindi sila nagbibigay ng visa.
Mm-hmm.
So ang India hindi nagbibigay ng visa sa mga Pilipino maging turista dito.
Mm-hmm.
The same way, ang mga Indians na gusto pumunta sa Pilipinas na maging turista lang, hindi pa pwede. So hindi pa pwede yan. No?
Mm-hmm.
Except for essential workers. So and then ang hirap pa dyan, even if you can get a visa, which is very difficult, ang hirap dyan yung commercial flights. Wala pa rin tayong commercial flights between India and the Philippines, except through the Middle East,
mm-hmm.
which is a mahaba proseso.
Yes.
So I recommend sa ating mga kababayan and the other Indians who are watching your program, to refrain muna, time out muna tayo sa biyahe. Because restricted nga dyan sa Pilipinas, meron tayong quarantine dyan, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So, dito sa India, walang quarantine. Pero hindi ka makakuha ng visa. So, that's the difficulty.
Oh, I see.
So, stay put muna tayo. Itay natin.
Mm-hmm.
And then in other states here, like Maharashtra, mm-hmm. where Mumbai is located, and Kerala,
opo.
In other states, napaka-stick to nila. Although, pag nakakuha ka ng visa, pupunta ka ng India, walang quarantine dito, no?
Mm-hmm.
Pero pag pumunta ka sa ibang state, may quarantine sila. So, pipili ka muna ng lugar. So, you have to check with the Indian embassy there
mm-hmm.
kung ano yung end destination mo sa India.
Mm-hmm.
Some areas are okay, Chennai, Calcutta, but some areas are very strict na kailangan ng quarantine at saka mga RT-PCR tests.
Mm-hmm.
So, makusunta muna sila.
Mm-hmm. How would you compare po yung lockdown measures dyan dito po sa atin sa Pilipinas? Like recently, as you saw earlier, President Duterte just retained the ECQ measures. We went back to ECQ lockdown again in some areas, major areas. Dyan po sa India, how would you compare it po?
Well, nakikita nga sa mga pinalalabas yung mga videos, no? Medyo dito sa Delhi, New Delhi, hindi masyadong stricto.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Pero doon sa sinabi ko mga lugar na talagang strict lockdown, talagang very strict, may curfew. Hindi ka pwedeng lumabas, uhulihin ka ng police. Okay? Mga pictures ng mga simulay, yung kinapalo ng yanto. Yung mga kapitika sa ulo, di ba?
Okay.
So may mga ganun sitwasyon doon. Pero ngayon, wala na ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
But uhulihin ka lang at pagkakalitan ka.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos mayroon mga ibang lumalabas nga na sa social media, isasakay ka doon sa sasakyan na may mga COVID positive. So nakakatakutan, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So pero sila yung out of the box situations or remedies.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, the people are following naman.
Mm-hmm.
Sumusunod naman ang mga kababayan dito. Dahil takot na rin sila magkasakit.
Mm-hmm.
Although as I said, yung death rate dito napakababa, less than 1%.
That's true. How is the work situation there in the embassy po? Kumusta po yung ating consular services po dyan? Apektado po ba? At ano po ba ang sitwasyon ng, how is your work situation? Is it work from home, 100%, 50% po?
Depende sa mga advice. Kasi every 2 weeks or every week or every month, nagbibigay ng advice ang local government dito. Mm-hmm. So, siguro sumunod namin yun. So, pag mababa ang sitwasyon, open kami. Mm-hmm. Every day. Mm-hmm. So, yung mga kababayan natin na kailangan magpa-review ng passport, mag-extend ng passport, okay yun. Mm-hmm. We're open 24/7. That is regular office hours. Mm-hmm. Pag sinabing stricto, lockdown, work from home kami lahat. Mm-hmm. But, we make it a point that we tell our kababayans and anybody to just email us and we answer all the emails. Mm-hmm. And then we give the schedules kung kailan sila pwede pupunta dito sa embassy. Mm-hmm. And so far naman, it has been working quite well. Eh sa akin naman, walang problema dito dahil dito ako nakatira sa compound. So 24/7 ako. So walang work from home. Kasi ang work from home, katabi ko yung embassy.
Yes.
So marami po kapukas tayo.
Okay, Ambassador, mabalik po tayo sa travel. Meron lang po akong itatanong. In August, there were special flights between India and the Philippines. And meron po bang ibang na-arrange na ganitong flights? If ever, what are the essential reasons for travel po?
Well, we were able to lobby with the Indian government na tawag na dyan yung Vande Bharat Mission. Kasi nung umpisa ng pandemic, May, June, July last year, ang daming standard na Pilipino dito na sumuwi sa atin and vice versa.
Opo.
Mas maraming Indians na na-standard dyan. Maraming Indian students dyan eh.
Opo.
Okay? So we were able to lobby with Air India, yung airlines ng Indian government. So nagkaroon sila ng Vande Bharat Mission. And with that, we were able to repatriate more than 1,000 Filipinos no? From here, going to Manila. Plus yung mga ibang chartered flights na nakuha ko sa ibang Indigo or SpiceJet. Mm-hmm. So marami tayong Pilipino na pauwi sa Pilipinas at vice versa, marami din mga Indians na nakauwi dito. Ngayon, tinigil nila yan because of this spike nga. With the last flight we had was, first week of February this year.
Mm-hmm.
But tapos nung natigil na. Mm-hmm. So we would have chartered flights. May mga Filipino-Indians dyan na nakausap ng ibang travel agency at saka ang Indigo.
Mm-hmm.
And they were able to arrange chartered flights.
Mm-hmm.
Tinigil yan itong February tapos na-cancel nga yung mga scheduled flights this March.
Mm-hmm.
So we hope that when the situation improves, kasi nag-order ang Indian government na no commercial flights unless you get an exemption from their Ministry of Aviation, Civil Aviation. And they gave the debt, they gave the period of April 31 or 30.
Mm-hmm.
So tapusin natin itong April and then hopefully we will be able to organize again chartered flights.
Mm-hmm. All right, maraming salamat po for your time, Ambassador. Baka meron ho kayong huling mensahe sa mga nanonood po sa inyo ngayon.
Well, ang importante, Alma, is all of us, whether you're in India or in the Philippines, stay safe. If there is any vaccine available, do take it right away. Huwag na natin hintayin na may mangyari pa at mag-ingat lang po tayo dahil delikado po ang sitwasyon both in India and the Philippines. At maraming salamat sa pagkakataon na ibinigay niyo sa akin ngayon para makaupang paalad ang ating mga kababayan at sana makarating sa mga kababayan natin dyan kung meron silang mga kaibigan o kamag-anak sa India. Just keep it, get in touch with me and we'll do whatever we can to help them. Maraming salamat sa iyo, Alma, at good afternoon.
Thank you very much, His Excellency Ramon Bagatsing Jr., the Philippine Ambassador to India. Thank you very much for your time on behalf of Eagle Broadcasting Corporation. Maraming salamat po.